Hello, I'm Garry Ho, one of the sports medicine physicians here at OrthoVirginia. And I wanted to spend a couple minutes today to answer a question that I hear all the time in the clinic. That is surrounding our use of platelet-rich plasma or PRP. A question I often get from patients is, how does PRP work? What is PRP? What can I expect if I get PRP treatment at OrthoVirginia? And so to answer some of those questions, I've prepared a couple of pictures and a couple of slides that I would like to share. At OrthoVirginia, we're part of a multi-specialty group, we spend a lot of time working hard on refining our techniques in order to get our patients the best possible outcome. And this is a couple slides that I've prepared to help illustrate. So what is PRP and what is the rationale behind it? So I often explain this to patients by saying that PRP is where we draw a sample of the patient's blood and we process it and concentrate it, usually spinning it down, to isolate a small portion of the blood that contains platelets, some white blood cells, some heavier proteins, in order to kind of purify it and concentrate that and then inject it back into an area that's damaged or has a degenerative process. And the purpose of this is to basically trigger a wound healing response in an area that needs more healing or more of a healing response. And so this graphic kind of shows that. So here you can see what we do is we draw a sample of the patient's blood, we concentrate and we spin it down, and we take a certain portion of it that contains these platelets as well as white blood cells, okay? So why do we focus so much on the platelets and why is it called platelet-rich plasma? Well, it really comes down to what we're trying to accomplish, and that is to trigger that wound healing response. You see, what happens when we actually get a cut, when we actually get a wound? When we get a cut or a wound, the body has a number of priorities. It needs to, one, stop bleeding, two, protect against or fight against infection, and three, start the healing process in order to lay the groundwork to heal and cover up the wound, to actually make that wound go away, to repair the area so it's no longer an open wound. So that process is fairly complex, and there's several different things that happen there, but it happens in stages, okay? What's interesting is the body isn't anything if not eloquent and well-designed. And so it turns out that platelets, these small little cell fragments that are floating around in our blood, actually plays a role in all of these processes, both in stopping bleeding, as well as fighting infection, as well as setting the stage for wound healing and reparative processes to patch up that wound, okay? One of the first things that happens when you get a cut is that you start to bleed. And the platelets are exposed to certain things, such as the air or even injured collagen fibers. It activates the platelets. The platelets basically change their shape and they help form a plug in order to form a blood clot in order to stop you from bleeding. And while it does that, those same platelets then release growth factors that actually send a signal to other cells, such as white blood cells, in order to come to the area to protect against infection. Some of those white blood cells play a role in actually cleaning up the debris and the devitalized and dead tissue in the area. And other white blood cells signal yet other cells to come in to start the healing. And the platelets also do that too. It has growth factors that basically act as a signal to call the other cells to come in order to start to lay down new protein and to start the healing process. Okay, so here's a graphic kind of showing that. And you can see on the left side, you can see you have a cartoon showing a wound bleeding, okay? And these little yellow circles here represent platelets. You can see immediately the platelets get into the area. They activate to form this plug, okay? This clot that's a combination of platelets and various proteins in order to stop bleeding from happening so that the red blood cells don't continue to bleed out. It also sends signals to recruit surrounding white blood cells, okay? Eventually continues to secrete signals so that other cell types come in and secrete protein fibers in order to eventually cause healing, okay? And this happens in stages, as you can imagine. And for the most part, this actually also requires some inflammation. So if you ever cut yourself, you get the bleeding, get the clot, you notice that as it heals, there's a little soreness in the area. There's a little bit of pain. There's even a little redness in the area. And that's because part of this wound healing process requires some inflammation. And that's actually one of the stages that happen during wound healing. You see here on the right side, a couple graphs kind of representing the different stages that happen in wound healing. You have an inflammatory stage or inflammation. You have proliferation, where there's a bunch of cell division and kind of depositing of new protein and new tissue. And then you have maturation or remodeling, where that newly laid down tissue has to then remodel and change shape in order to adapt and mature to fully be able to function and provide a good seal, or in the case of a tendon, in order to be more functional, to be able to pull the load that you want to apply to the tendon. So as such, when people get PRP, because it goes through those stages, people will feel different symptoms. I talked about that inflammation. So often when people first get PRP, they get an acute inflammatory reaction, and that's actually normal, okay? Often when I talk about what to expect after getting a PRP treatment, if this is baseline zero, okay, we want to get you improved to say 100% in a perfect world, okay, you're actually going to feel worse before you feel better. In fact, people can sometimes have a very robust inflammatory reaction, and they'll feel much worse. And that's pretty soon. It's in the first day or two of getting the treatment. And most people will kind of hit rock bottom between day 2 to 4. And it varies from person to person. And then they'll start to peel off of rock bottom between day 5 to 7. And somewhere along 2 weeks or so, patients are back to baseline. And at this point in time, you know, they might feel like not much has happened, that there hasn't been much benefit in the PRP. But this initial trough, you know, this feeling worse, where they might feel worse than baseline. So not only are they not any better, they're like negative 100%, okay, when it comes to their symptoms. That actually corresponds to the inflammatory stage of PRP. And likewise, everything else that follows corresponds to a different stage, different set of cell processes as part of the wound healing, okay? So usually after people reach baseline, they slowly start to get better. And it varies how quickly and how much they get better, depending on your individual biology. Eventually, people will plateau. Usually the plateau comes at about 8 to 12 weeks. And hopefully we plateau at a good amount, more than 80%. If we plateau lower, this is where we might consider a repeat treatment. But this is sort of a typical curve of the majority of responders who get PRP treatment. You feel worse, then you peel off of rock bottom, you get back to baseline zero, no better, and then you slowly start to get better, okay? Not everybody responds similarly. You know, as people, we're all individual. Our biology is different. We're of different ages. We come in all shapes and sizes. And as such, we each have a slightly different response to wound healing. There are people who are very fast responders, who are just super healers, and those of us who are much slower. And so this graph just illustrates that there are groups of people who respond faster, slower, or more or less, or completely, depending on your individual biology. So just to kind of wrap it up here, PRP is fairly complex. But realize that what we're trying to do is to trigger a wound healing response in order to achieve a goal. And that is, in the case of something that needs to heal, like a tendon or a ligament, we're trying to basically encourage that tissue to heal, proliferate, and then remodel. In the case of other conditions, part of that healing wound response is where the body starts to kind of basically control that acute inflammation, that breakdown inflammation, and switch to a more buildup inflammation. And that's actually something the PRP might do, say, in a condition like osteoarthritis. So hopefully with that, this has been helpful. I know I kind of went across some pretty deep science there. Certainly, if you have questions about platelet-rich plasma or PRP, speak to one of our providers here at OrthoVirginia, who does a lot of orthobiologics and regenerative medicine, and we'd be happy to answer those questions and help you decide whether PRP is something right for you.